Today we'll be showing you some of our navigation equipment that we use for Chadwick. We have a parallel ruler, a set of navigational triangles, dividers and a compass, and obviously our pencil or clutch pencil. So for the first example, we have a position, and we'll be doing the position using our parallel rulers. So we have a position at 55.6, so with the parallel rulers in line with one of the latitude lines, we are going up to 55.55.246. That's our line of latitude. Now we need our line of longitude, 14.33, so 14.33 will be somewhere over here. Turning around the parallel ruler, putting the line on top of one of the longitudinal lines onto the chart, we have it on 30, moving to 14.14, as we can see here, 33, so 31, 32, 33. And that will be our first position for our course. For our second position, we'll be using the navigational triangles. That way, we have an idea of how to use both. So our second position is 36.06.6. So 36, so we have the center of the triangle on top of the longitudinal line. And we need 05.06.6, so we need to go this way. So with the other triangle, holding the other triangle alongside to it, and we're holding it in straight, we move this one in the other direction. So that's 05.06.6. The second is 14.17, so we'll be somewhere over here. So for our 14.17, we'll be using the same, our triangle in line with latitude line, the other triangle adjacent to it, so we can slide over it, and we have 15.16.17, and that is our second position. We will be joining the positions with a course line, and for this we'll be using the parallel rulers. The idea of parallel rulers is due that they are longer. These parallel rulers that currently today I'm using are quite short, but you can find parallel rulers up to also a meter or even more longer. So here we have joined our positions with our course line. Now, what is the direction of the course line? So by holding the parallel ruler in place and moving our parallel ruler one time, we move over to our compass rules. When we get in the middle, so we mark the middle, mark on one side, we mark on the other side. We get back here, keep it in line. So with that way we have two course lines. So if we go back to our compass, if we're going in our north-westerly directions, we'll be going on course 310.5 degrees. If we are going on a course southerly direction, on the southeast direction, we are going on a course of 130.5 degrees. The option of using the dividers is the dividers. You could also make the position by getting, for example, 35.55.6. So we have from one of the angles 35.55.6, and that is the same over here. We can also use our dividers to measure a distance, and we'll be going to measure our course line. So coming adjacent to our course line, somewhere in the middle, we get a distance of 5 nautical miles. going over here, we have, that's 5, 10, 15, 16, 17. So we have a distance of 17 nautical miles. The use of the compass is of the same thing. So the difference is that you can mark more with it. So if we go over here again, we measure our 5 miles. We go in the middle of our position. 5, 10, 15, 16, 17 nautical miles. The other thing is with a compass or with a divider, you can measure a distance off. For example, we have here our point from our course line. So that means that from our course line to our point, we'll be having a distance of 2.25 nautical miles. I think that's all for today. Thank you for watching.